So back in the 90s, my older brother's best friend comes over to the house. He brings over a Sega Genesis. Now at the time, I had never seen one, but upon seeing it, it looked great. He brought over a few games. He brought Sonic 2, Moonwalker, and also Streets of Rage 1 and 2. I got Streets of Rage and I think, that's a really cool title for a game. And we popped in the first one and frankly, it was a lot of fun. The story is very simple and I love it for that. The story is that the nefarious Mr. X and his cronies have taken over the city. Now, this city is now in chaos. So in order to fix it, we call upon these three ex-cops named Adam Hunter, Blaze Fielding, and Axel Stone. It is up to these three great citizens to stop the dastardly Mr. X and his goons once and for all. In order to do that, you need to confront Mr. X in his mansion, but before he can do that, you need to cross the Streets of Rage. Yeah. So one of the cool things about this game is that each character has their own strengths and weaknesses. And that's great because it gives the game more replayability. I want to have incentive to play as all three characters, and now I have it. And speaking of cool things, I can't ever forget the special attack. You know, when I first saw the special attack, I was just in awe of how cool it looked. You call upon a police car, and that police car comes in. One of the police officers has a rocket launcher, and he shoots a rocket launcher, and either destroys all the goons, or if you're fighting a boss, it takes away a good chunk of their health, which is also really important. You can find more of these by finding police car icons that are in some of the stages, but in Stage 8, you can't use the attack, which is unfortunate because it is a really cool and useful attack. But it also makes the stage harder, which, from what I remember, it was. You know, the final fight with Mr. X is really cool, and he's a reasonable challenge. But what I remember most is what happens before you fight him. See, if you're playing one player or two players, before you fight him, he gives you the option of joining him. If you're playing two players, you can then choose to turn on your partner. And if you turn on your partner and you beat your partner and also beat Mr. X, you then take Mr. X's place and now you're the boss, which is really cool because at the time, I had never played a game with a bad ending before. But it was a really cool twist and frankly, it gives the game some more replayability and that's great. I just love the idea of having that choice. In terms of what I didn't like, there's just one thing. The sprites are just way too small for my liking, and frankly, they lack detail. And that does hurt the game a bit, but overall, it's still a really enjoyable game. I played on my new 3DS a few months ago, and frankly, I'm happy I got it. You know, the boss fight, and as for the con, well, just one, really. I don't like the fact that